is another exciting time on television. This is Sports Matters. My name is Ijoma Mokulu. Today on the show, it promises to be very interesting as we bring you results from last night's Champions League finals. And you know, with midweek football coming back, we need to have all the fun. I have really great minds in the studio. But before we go into all of the analysis for today, just in 1 hour, we'll have to give you first off our talking points. The Nigerian Women Football League set to start a new season with just 13 clubs. And Bayelsa Queens are champions of the Flying Officers Cup 2020. Sports Minister gives NFF new order on the national team coach Gerard Lord. And then the Presidential Task Force rejects December 3rd kickoff date for national sports and festivals. Former Super Eagles striker Tijani Babangida has been appointed president of the Professional Players Union of Nigeria. And we'll take you through to the Foreign Saints and Club Rouge Nigerians Imani Dennis misses out on their Champions League game last night. We want to really know why. And then Borussia Dortmund's Ellen Haaland breaks another Champions League record. And then we'll take you through all of the Champions League results from last night. And of course, the fixtures for the Champions League game today. And we'll wrap it up with the FIFA Football Awards 2020. All of the nominees in the men's and category, and of course the coach of the century. All of these talking points will bring to you in the top of the hour. But I'll take a quick break. When we come back from that break, I'll introduce to you our in-house analyst, and then we'll start working. We'll be right back. Do stay with us. Welcome back. If you're just tuning in, you have not missed anything because we are just about to start. I have with me today on the show, Jua Nwakego, as usual, the tall, dark, Ghanaian-looking brother of mine. Jua, how are you today?
I'm all right, but I wonder why you call me a Ghanaian.
Maybe because you have the Ghanaian color, right?
Who said that?
You've got the Ghanaian color.
Okay, fine. I'm not a Ghanaian. I'm from West Africa.
No, but he's not a Ghanaian.
I'm from West Africa.
Of course, he's from West Africa.
Hey, so
my
good to
West
be here to talk
African
sports.
Nigerian looking brother.
Well, yeah, it's good to talk sports on a Wednesday. Thank you very much for having me.
Of course, as usual. And then we have this one is close to my heart. Tayo, how are you today?
I'm fine, Ijoma. Good afternoon.
This one, are you?
You are looking.
Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you. As usual.
Yes.
Please don't forget to add as usual. You know we have our own troubles.
Yes.
But thank you for the compliment. And no, nice to have you here again.
Thanks
after a long while. Tayo joins us again. Joins me again, not us, because he's usually here. Okay, guys, so let's go into all of what is happening. We have a full package for you today, and our talking points will make you want to stay glued to your TV set. And of course, you can even call us in when you see the numbers displayed on your TV screen. Okay, so guys, the Women League, 4 p.m. today, we'll have the final list of the clubs that will make it through to the 2019-2020 season. Now, Aisha Folode is saying she will kickstart with 13 of them, owing to the fact that they give them over 2 months to prepare, over 2 months to make sure they meet all of the criteria and then meet the deadline. Now, we came from 10 clubs who met the deadline to 13 clubs, and today, 4 p.m., just 1 hour after the show, we'll know if we are going to have the 20 list or if we are going to have just 13. Now, do you think it's just the best thing to do? Remember, we've been able to just set out fixtures for this particular season, and now we are seeing all of this. Joel?
Well, 13 clubs. That means the information we have is not even correct. If they have to hold the meeting till like 5 p.m. to know if we can have the 20 teams, you know, on the log. But it's quite funny. Okay, fine. What if we start with 13? Then tomorrow, like five other teams comes and say, okay, how you gonna fuse this?
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna be a problem for them. So, but I wonder what they're doing all this while. Does it mean we've been seeing all the while, a lot of clubs, they don't even have what it takes to be, to play the NWFL. That is the meaning. Mm-hmm. Because if you have other teams that are not prepared, what does that mean? You don't have good stadiums. You can't even pay salaries. Mm-hmm. You're not even worthy to be in the league. Mm-hmm. So there's no point. Why don't you just wait till 5 p.m. and see what happens?
Okay, I think they will eventually want to wait till 9 p.m. Remember that the league starts in NSO. They just want to put their house in order and be sure that if you are not going to make this meet this deadline now, that means you are not ever going to meet it for the 2020 league.
That's the meaning.
And now, tired, they said they are going to relegate any particular team who, oh my God, any particular team that doesn't make it to the regular season, they're going to demote them. How does this, can you just help me make it make sense? And we're talking about Sunshine Queens, Heartland Queens, and Dream Stars. They're saying if these three probably don't just come up with their 4 p.m. deadline, then they're going to demote them. Is that how football is being, is that how we administer football?
Well, for me, I just like Joella said, the first thing first, the problem with our football is we are never organized. But kudos to the women, they've been doing wonderfully well when you look at the national team. But you know, the bulk of the blame still goes to the administrators, because over the years we never had a well-structured women league. Mm-hmm. So probably because of this, maybe, because for me it's still tentative. Mm-hmm. Even when we are having league this season, it doesn't mean we are going to, it's going to be a top notch. Mm-hmm. It will be at the same level with what you see out there, because by now Nigeria is the giant of Africa and we are supposed to see it in every facet. Mm-hmm. And even the normal league, the NPFL, is not doing well. So, but for
us, it's not doing well. Like, we don't even know where we want it.
We don't have a league.
Just like the sports festival that we have been hoping that will start. Mm-hmm. Just yesterday, mm-hmm.
we told that story.
So we never can tell. Tomorrow, you can hear another news that the league is not starting anymore. Mm-hmm. So these are some of the issues that we have. But well, you know, Aisha Fayode cannot go it all. Mm-hmm. So I believe there are people sitting on the board that could look into this. Mm-hmm. But for me, like Joel said, it doesn't, because how can you have 13 clubs
as against,
and at the end of the day, when you start, maybe five others will join, and you know.
No, but for me, if we start, we already have started. You cannot start with 13 and tomorrow you want to add 2 or 3. It's not possible, because how are you going to even mash out all of those fixtures for them? How are you going? Because I said, if you are not ready, it's better we just wait until these clubs are ready. But then it's taking like forever. And I think this is just like the best thing to do, so that next season you begin to know if you are not ready. That means you just tell them, we are not going to participate this season. It's better we just stay back, or like go there and you don't get to pay player mm-hmm. salaries. Mm-hmm. You don't get to honor matches. Yeah. I've seen a particular game where a team from Accra cannot even make the journey to Lagos, mm-hmm. just because they don't have the finances for it. So if that's, it's just 13, why not you go ahead with the 13? And then let there not be any other foul play. If you're starting with 13, let the 13 just go ahead, start the league and finish it. Because if you're going to infuse any other team, then where is the credibility? Like you said, giants of Africa. For me, I don't think we are even giants in anything anymore. Because if the giants of Africa, the NPFL should have started. Mm. Just like you rightly said, the women are even trying to do their best, making sure that the 13 already picked have completed all the requirements. That means we're not going to come out tomorrow to hear and you're owing us and we couldn't make the match, mm. this, that. You know, that is just like, yeah. my opinion.
And then another thing is quickly, the facilities, because I understand that majority of the leagues, the clubs in Europe, they use the same stadium, mm-hmm. like Arsenal, female yeah. team. And so which team facilities are these ladies using?
They're using the same stadium, the same place the NPFL 2 uses. That's the same place. FC Robo of Lagos, I think, is still this stadium at Agege Township Stadium.
Does the female team, are they being owned by the male teams?
That's the problem.
No, they are not. But then like you can easily share.
Chelsea, Man City, they are owned.
No, they share facilities.
You see, the main of this whole thing is they've stopped chasing black boats at night. That is what I feel. Because right now, they're only letting the public believe, look, we are up and doing, we know what we're doing, we're going to start with 13 teams. Coming out to look to make us believe they are serious.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? But I know it's not going to end very well.
Mm.
Because in the next couple of hours, we're going to hear two teams are okay.
Yeah,
we're
going to
have 15 teams.
Yeah.
For God's sake, I wonder where this whole thing will drive us to.
I think I perfectly agree with Joel. And when it's 5 p.m. today, we may hear two other teams are ready to join. And then we'll move from 13 to 15. And then before the December 9th, of course, December 9th is the estimated date for the kickoff of the end of the NFL. We may begin to hear other stories that other clubs are joining. And then everything will just, come into shambles. But then let me quickly read out the teams that are ready. FC Rubber of Lagos is ready, and Nasarawa Amazon are ready. Edo Queens are through. Pelican Stars, as of 2 days ago, we are still here and there, and they are still going to play as Saturdays. So you can imagine. So they've been able to keep them qualified and ready. So Pelican Stars have joined the log. Ocean Babes are there, Bayasa Queens, Royal Queens, Abia Angels of Umahe, we have our Adamawa Queens, and of course we have our Rivers Angels of Port Harcourt and Delta Queens, and then Conference Queen and Igbo Angels are all of the 13 teams, and the NWFA has set and ready to kickstart the come December 9th. Hopefully, that date is not changed, but then we'll keep you abreast of all of the information. This time Friday, Joel and Prince Will and the Francisca will come up to give you the developing story as I begin to manage. Okay, so guys, let's just move away from it. Then let's talk about the Flying Officers Cup. I don't know who's excited. For me, I think I'm excited at the female pre-season tournament. This is the pre-season tournament, and it went beautifully well. I think it's one tournament that was organized that made sense, if you ask me. 8 teams, and then we had the winners, and then the cash prize for the first time. They said they needed to pay the money and give it to them instantly, and it was done. And I said, so what is happening? But first of all, let's talk about the Flying Officers Cup and the person who we are honoring in this particular event.
It's a good one, just like you said, and that's one of the things to show that women are actually they are organized. Because for me, left to me, I've said it over time, I don't dig super. I prefer those ladies. Even when they go to competition and it seems they are not good enough, they will still give their best to do the nation proud. So this is a very good development. But the only sad thing is Arutile died, because we've had so many big, bright minds in this country. So it just died, but it's a fantastic one that Aisha Fowler has been able to organize a competition of this magnitude in our honor. So it's a good one, and we appreciate the female folk for that.
Okay, so Joel, we have a cash prize of 500,000 for the winners by Asakuni. And then we have 300,000 naira to Nasarawa Amazon, 200,000 naira for a good print for coming in 10th place, and we have 150,000 naira going to Nigeria for their 4th and place and finishing. But every other team that participated got 60,000 naira for participating.
In fact, I was wow when I heard this. You know, every team that participated got 60,000. Are you sure this must have got to them? We're supposed to be jubilating for things like it to happen in this country. All the teams that participated. Wow, that's 8 wonder of the world. I really appreciate Aisha Falodo for this feat. And it's a good one, like he said, for development of football in Nigeria. And this lady that died, yes, it's so sad. But I hope there has to be continuity, because it's not just doing it once, one stop and that's all. It has to continue. It has to keep coming. You have to keep running, for us to really, mortalize this lady, because I don't think anything like that happened in this country, You know, it's so sad for the family. I really pray God give them the fortitude to bear the loss, and let's keep the flag flying and keep it happening.
Sorry for cutting. For the money, it might not be big, but it's an encouragement. Just like Joella said, you don't have to give them. You have to promise them 100 million that, you know, if it's just 50,000 and you are able to pay. And I'm just hoping one day you are going to have a woman sitting in that glass house. Probably by then we'll get our history, because all these guys that are running our football, I don't know. Seriously, I don't know.
To know the guys running our football. But then I want to thank the organizers of this particular Flying Officers Cup, Paul Ede. He changed actually the competition name to this Flying Officer just to, you know, tell the family of Tolulope that she has done well for Nigeria.
Yeah.
Anywhere she is today, and we want to thank you for all your service to the Nigerian Army and the Nigerian Navy. For all your services, we want to say thank you very much. And her mom was there in the kickoff ceremony, and she did the honors. Aisha followed, and every other person who been able to put this competition together. Thank you, and may you continue to rest in peace. You will never be forgotten. That is why this competition is in your honor. Thank you again for all your services. Okay, away from that, let's look at the one that has got people talking. That is Sports Minister. I know Tayo cannot just wait. Tayo can't wait to, you know, begin to just tell us why we still have the same set of people. And the same, I don't understand it, but I'm trying to understand it. The NFL, the Sports Minister Sunday Dare, just gave out rules to the NFF, that is the president of NFF, Ahmadu Pinnick, that the current coach general must follow. And we, if you hear some of these rules, or then you begin to wonder if he didn't just renew his contract. He renewed his contract. He was offered a pay cut. He took it. So why didn't you bring all of this? Okay, let me even read out some of the ridiculous instructions that has been given to General. They said the NFF must provide a physical trainer. They must provide a nutritionist, they must provide a psychologist, and they must provide two additional match readers, people that read the match. Although we have one in the team already, I wonder why we need two match readers. And away from two match readers, they've told him, the coach, that he must infuse four MPFL players in his team. Guys,
well, for me, I don't think he needed to be told to infuse, for it's the normal thing. This is a Nigerian national side.
Are you going to infuse players that are not playing?
The issue is whether they are playing or not. It's all boils down to the fault of, because the question is, who is the executive director of MPFL? Shehu Diko. The guy is a, to me, there are some things we are not supposed to be saying on it. You know, as a media practice, they will come after, but it's a slap on his face. That as an executive director, none of your players is making the team, and you are still sitting there as the executive director of the MPFL. You know, over the years you had beautiful Nigerian, like the likes of Amokachi, Emmanuel Amunike, Mutia. Some of these guys were picked on the streets. So I see no reasons, you know, today we are going to start our league, tomorrow we are going to play an abridged league, you know, owing player salary and all of this. These are some of the problems. And Genetro might not be the major problem of Nigerian football. But he was appointed by some people. But it's also part of the problem. We've had coaches that have done better than this guy in this country. The likes of Ahmadu Shuaibu, they won Ahmadu Shuaibu won silver in Ghana, Nigeria 2000. Qualified us for the World Cup. He was sacked. So yeah. What is wrong? What are they benefiting from this guy? Is there anything they are not telling Nigerians? Why will you keep him on the job? And for the sports minister, last week he said he's going to take a drastic action. Probably some people have spoken to him, that guy just need to cool down. So coming out with all this, it means they must have told him some things. Probably they want to frustrate him, because I don't expect him to have come out, you want to give him match reader, These are not what we need. We need to structure this thing. Mm-hmm. It's a disgrace that we go to competition and at the end of, because with this display, I don't see Nigeria going to the AFCON and doing us proud. To be serious.
Okay, let me even stay with you, Joel. You need two match readers. When are they going to read this match? Is it pre-game? Is it in the game? Or is it post-game? When are they actually going to read this game? Because if you look at it, when the Super Eagles come for a particular tournament qualifier, barely 10 days. They have barely 10 days to stay in camp. So when are they supposed to read this particular game?
Now let me start with this. Sorry, Dari. Okay. Those things you brought out, for God's sake, this is what's happening in Europe. You don't need to come out and say you want match readers, you want a nutritionist, you want a psychologist. Now, if you look at a team, for example, like Man United, you see the coach, the manager. Because now our job is not defined here in Nigeria. Mm-hmm. For God's sake, I asked the question, one of the employees, who is this man? They said he's a coach. Mm-hmm. Do they even know the definition of a coach? A coach is someone that trains you from nothing to something that makes you look perfect in this particular field. Mm-hmm. He's not even a technical advisor because you don't have what it takes. He doesn't have a CV. Mm-hmm. He doesn't have a CV. He said he is part of the problem, but the problem starts from the administrators, which have to be structured. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? Now, and two, there are people that work with coaches. They have their own staff. Mm-hmm. There's a team doctor, there's a psychologist, mm-hmm. there's a nutritionist. They come with the coaching crew. Mm-hmm. When the match is going on, you see them talking to the coach, probably like on a tablet, on a paper, look, setting tactical information for the coach, even telling the player, look, this is how you're going to play. Mm-hmm. Those are the thinking men. This is what you should have in the national team. Mm-hmm. Now you're bringing a Yobo. Yobo doesn't have a coaching certificate.
He doesn't have one.
I don't know why he retired early. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So look, to me, roles should be sacked and the FA should be restructured. I am very happy the players' union is coming up. This is one of the things they have to look at. Please, Tijan Babangida and his men, they have to look at the FA. The FA has to be restructured. Mm-hmm. How can you bring a man without no CV turning to handle the national team? You are winning the game 4-0 and you went to sleep. And you open equalize 4-4. Come on, I wouldn't even do that.
I think that was even the wake-up call. I think all of this trouble started with when we played the qualifiers. Because before the qualifiers, everybody was just calm and cool. Nobody was saying, okay, we are going to I'm going to draw out. Although we know that he is, in fact, he's one of the major...
You know, at one point, the minister was saying, I want to see his record, his CV, his file. Does it mean when this man was employed, he just came through the back door and got the job and got the notice? But come on, for God's sake, Nigeria should wake up. We don't need this.
The most annoying thing is, whenever I want to get a coach, you will be hearing Nigeria is scouting for a world-class coach. Mm-hmm. For Falcons, that was what you were saying. At the end of the day, we just see a pensioner from nowhere. They are just making money.
This man has never won anything in his...
Fine, we might not be able to pay these guys. Mm-hmm. We might not be able to pay the likes of Businde, Mourinho, guy. But let's get a coach that has done something in Africa. Mm-hmm. Those are the coaches that have record in Africa. They understand the terrain. Mm-hmm. It's not when we go to Ferguson, let's get a coach that knows his onions.
Talking about the NPFL, you know, because it was mandated to look, you have to go to the NPFL and pick some players.
Pick four mandatory players.
The league is not starting. Even if the league starts. Mm-hmm. Once upon a time, a coach was telling, Rojo told a player, I'm going to mention his name, Bolaji Saki, mm-hmm. you are too old to play in the Super Eagles. Mm-hmm. I was like, what are you talking about? Mm-hmm. Now, Bolaji Saki is somewhere in one of the African countries, doing very well, earning a lot of money. Mm-hmm. I'm going to say this here and now. It is easy playing abroad in the Nigerian league. Mm-hmm. Because you keep having these players year in, year out. They don't want to give chance for the amateur players to even come in.
Yeah.
That's one of the reasons they had to go and start the private league. Mm-hmm. The private league is on. They started last week.
Yeah.
Because there is... It seems there's no future for... Even the date is not even sure.
It's not certain. It's not even certain. But though I still have issues. And when you say a nutritionist, I think the doctor in the team doctor is doing their job. All he needs to do if we just have 5 or 10 days to stay in camp, just like he did in the last qualifiers, is to go to the hotel management and tell them this is the meal prep for these players. Mm-hmm. And he sees to eat anytime they come to eat. Mm-hmm. So if you see a nutritionist, yes, everything deserves to have one. But the NFF are still crying out loud that they don't have money. You don't have money to just bring the basic, just the very basics to the national team. And you want a man who just is going about his business to do otherwise. Nagenaro is not a fan of the NPFA. He has always said it. If you want to get to my team, get yourself in Europe and get yourself some playing time before I can put in the national team. It's been like that if since he was been coach. It has always been like that. He has never liked the fact that
in NPFA, the Zambia national team won the Cup of Nations without a player in Europe.
Their league is working. If you are the coach of the national team, are you going to go back to the league to pick your players?
First of all, I won't accept the job of a coach because there's no structure. Why would I come in and
let's not even talk about structure. I'm saying if you are the coach.
Before now, we heard of two of these guys that won NPFL award. I've forgotten their name. Was it not last year or 2 years ago? Mm-hmm. One score about 20 goals.
Yeah.
If you score 20 goals in Nigerian league, you can't tell me all the players in our league. There is none.
At least we have our goalkeeper there now.
20 goals. What about penalties?
No, but then if the league were to be functional,
you can't tell me of all the players in Nigerian league, there is none that can make.
What I'm saying is, at the end of the league, yeah, you have the best goalkeeper, you have the best striker, you have the best midfielder, and the best defender. But the last chance, we didn't see this set of people. Mm-hmm. Sorry, I'm taking you back. Mm-hmm. We didn't see these people. So where are they? So who did they take to the chance?
Mm-hmm. All right. Nigerian football is still what it is. Would always get better. I used to say it anytime, any day. Would have to just get better and get into it because the world is leaving Nigeria behind. Africa is leaving Nigeria behind. If we do not qualify for the Nations Cup, then Nigeria will begin to ask themselves questions. Then the sports ministry and NFF would have Nigerians to answer huge questions from. Away from that, let's look at the presidential task force rejecting the December 3rd kick-off date for the National Sports Festival. And Joel, I want to ask, if we don't have the National Sports Festival this year, will there be any problem? Would Nigeria not continue? Won't this same competition come up probably early next year because of the back and forth we've had so far with the resumption of the National Sports Festival?
I think Sunday Yaridaris should first of all give us his timetable for the year or for 4 years. You know, I would love to say his timetable.
4 years?
Yeah, because he's going to be there for 4 years.
And then you said we don't have a structure.
He's going to be there for 4 years and he got 2.7 billion naira from FGN to run sport for 4 years. I wonder who's going to manage that. Now, Sports Festival is coming up. The date is not even sure. There is no date. There's no sports festival for this year.
Yeah.
And now the Olympics is coming up next year, June. And almost all the teams are in camp. Mm-hmm. So what are you doing with the sports festival? Mm-hmm. Are you going to fish out talent for 2 years later? If you tell me that, fine.
Yeah. If you tell me,
if you tell me you're going to bring out talent for 2 years later or the next Olympic, I'm going to take that. We're not going to tell me you're going to bring out talent for the Olympic that's coming up
in 6 months
or the All African Games in less than how many months? Mm-hmm. Because you're going to train them. You're going to take them to Europe. For they're going to play friendlies upon mix up with other people, all sports right now. Because, see, to me, there is no point for a sports festival. Mm-hmm. But if they insist on it, who am I?
Okay, Tayo, every other contact sport is back. Because if you look at it this way, you have to flip it to and look at it the other way. Now, I can't find the reason. I told you before we came on set, I can't find the reason why every other contact sport should be back. And then you are holding and you're stopping the sports festival. If it's not as important, because to the organizers it's as important because the Olympics are just around the corner. But then what can you say? Can you just make it make sense that every other contact sport is back and then you are still refusing the National Sports Festival? Is it that we don't have money to even organize this?
Well, for me, I don't know. I just feel it's like lack of communication, because like the deputy governor of Edo State was saying, he said they've not been getting feedback from the presidential task force, that they've not given them their awards, so they don't know, so they cannot go ahead until the president has given up. So that means all the razzmatazz we've been seeing in the media is just and Nigerians, you will be complaining Nigerians don't watch Nigerian League. You don't.
And then now we want to watch Nigerian League, and we are just.
Because the truth is, back then, I could mention athletes in Nigeria, but today, I don't even know. Because
you don't even know. Established athletes in Nigeria. I didn't even find it difficult. The last time I spoke to Funke Oshinaike, I was very close to tears because she said she has been in camp all by herself. So she needs money to even put herself in camp, pay her trainer, pay her nutritionist. Nobody is doing that for her. She's even a top athlete. Mm-hmm. Now, take it back to the ones depending solely on the government. Then you begin to see why.
I want them to be gold for you.
The last time was Nepiorisi heading the wrestlers, mm-hmm. female wrestlers, they're supposed to go to Serbia for a tournament which was cancelled. I was even happy it was cancelled because people said, look, we've not been training. What are we going there to do?
You're just going there to make up numbers, I can assure you that. But then away from all of this, I just hope they come to a common ground and see if this festival should go on, or take it early next year, prepare the athletes you can for the Olympics, and then see how many goals we can get from the Olympics. Okay, so let's finally take on the Super Eagles player Tijani Babangida, who was appointed the president of Professionals and Player Union of Nigeria, and our own Prince Winovisan is in that committee, and we are so happy and proud. I'm happy for you, I'm proud of you, my boss, and I'm very sure you're going there just to, you know, serve the country and do so well. We have a short clip from the president himself, Tijani Babangida, and Ipeba, who is his first, I think his first vice president, and they had this chat with Jewel in their unveiling. Let's take that video. When we come back, we'll take you straight to the foreign stage. We'll be right back.
That very good news is coming their way. Their pension, their insurance, health insurance, all are coming. Gone will be the days where you will see a Nigerian player finishing football and just be on the street without a job or without anything. We are going to see that we make this, during my administration, we'll make sure that we make everything perfectly for the players' welfare. Of course, we want to do a lot, we want to organize a lot of tournament from unders. We will do even the retired players apart from the grassroots. We are going to touch all aspects of football in Nigeria.
The next for a very long time. There's a lot of issues. It has been a divided house, so we can all come together and sort these problems. I think it's great for the players' union, and I think the players' union, we all know what the players' union is all about. It's supporting our players, supporting our past players, you know. So those are the roles the players' unions have to play, you know. So I'm happy here, I'm privileged to be a part of it, and I want to say, if not for Jala, who I have a lot of respect, and he's a man of honor, who has really convinced me to be part of it. I really didn't want to be part of it, sincerely, but I think it's always very important for us to play a role, to see how we can support ourselves, you know, my constituency as a footballer, you know. I see that's why I'm here. So it's a good day. I wish President Babangida best of luck. I wish him should have the wisdom to take this players' union to the next level, and for us who are assist him, we continue to tell him the truth.
Well, thank you very much.